Grounded, I would say, is the best way to put it. But the Gnar last pick, we saw it from White Knight earlier, yesterday, I believe. He was popping off. I do think Kennen is good into the Gnar. Historically, it's almost like a counter pick. You saw it in, like, C-Champ. He's not really seen the meta too much.
But before they can even realistically use the composition, we have to keep our eye on the laning phase. That's going to be a hook into the level 1. But keep in mind, Inspired is on the way. This is a level 3 Promise Q. Definitely overstepping, but maybe they can finish off Trimby to get it started. But that's so much damage coming in. That's the Dark Harvest is now reset for Inspired as well. Big chunk out of Jeskla. And this is about as bad as it could go. The Flash. Already burned.
Was looking some kind of gank, does get spotted out by the ward from Trimby, and they do have to stick around there. Trimby, no flash.
No ignite. The hook is going to connect. Trimby now going to be in trouble. Zanzara moving in, going to go for the crystal, going to get the follow, but that's the kill back in return. Good one for one for Trimby and Kadril. We might not even get to think about
allow him to shove out that wave. No TP available for Nukeduck. He has just ticked over to level 6. Is Jomame is continuing to poke here. Not sure when his level 6 comes in. Should just be a few more creeps.
And while Sandra's hovering around this bot side, Inspired is free farming, but they do land
the
no flash on Trimby.
Over and over again. Promise Q just can't miss. This Blitzcrank is an easy target for him. Jeskla manages to make it out as well.
Wave's
and
get trimmed out, and the wave will be fine. So Zanzar has flash. They do land the stun.
Flash immediately going to get the ult to follow up. Nukeduck waiting, trying to line up as much damage as humanly possible. He's going to throw down the ultimate, and Larson drops. Excellent setup
might
there.
Be a little bit better for Rogue in terms of strength of schedule. Mad Lions into G2 next week for Rogue is a tall task.
Banger after banger, the back-to-back. You love to see it. Rogue versus Mad, summer split. First. We can start roaming the map and getting our bot lane active on the map as we saw.
Spire getting collapsed on Zanzara, moving in though onto Larson.
Into the lantern,
and pulled back into the lantern, into the wall. Now immediately slowed up. Nukeduck says, okay, boys.
There
my time
is.
To shine.
That's
push
the interaction.
Q. The stun to knock him back. It's clean, but the damage isn't quite there to finish Larson off. It does, however, mean that they have unlimited access to this mid lane. That said, in the meantime.
And the XP numbers. Look at Jeskla, level 8, Handsome at level 9, Trimby level 6, Promise Q level 7. So Trimby's essentially giving himself up a little bit to get Hans as far ahead as he backs off. He should be pretty safe, whereas Handsome is essentially taking a tier 2 in White Knight's face because he has no vision. So Astralis need to trade this for something. Push in mid, try and get mid tower tier 1 now because so many members have showed top. Try and bring the Syndra towards mid or bring the bot lane from mid towards bot, try and get some towers back.
So much control of the map has just been. Look at the vision on the top side as well from Rogue. That is their territory now for as long as they want it to be. Astralis are going to take the mid lane. They've got the lantern there to get out. But
he doesn't have a QSS yet. He's a level down on Nukeduck. So this Lucian is not very, very powerful going into this third dragon fight. Whereas Astralis, it's Ocean Soul. They're giving up the third dragon. So that means Dragon Soul point for Astralis, Ocean Soul, even gold lead. Whichever team can find the right engage first will essentially get the neutral objective whenever they want.
Promise Q
flashing the
flash, no! Sama with the collector. So it's also going to have to give a little bit of respect to him. And there we go!
There is the collector! I love it! I love to see it! This interaction is a composition. Skarn doesn't want to ult them, but no one's a tank on Rogue's composition, and no one can face check. So Zanzara is basically, he's got 5 targets that he can choose from, and only 2 of them have a QSS. How do they break this vision line? They go through mid, try and push the wave in, and then contest afterwards.
Suppressed.
I think that was a bait from Hansama. I think he tried to bait Zanzara's ult there.
That's what he made, but the hook lands. Trimby gonna use his QSS as well. White Knight on the front line. Immediately they're gonna go for the sleep. That's 2 members, 3 members, drowsy. Can they get the set of the follow from Odawamne? He's looking to clean house. Odawamne doing big work as Hansama takes down White Knight. Promise Q has to run for the hills and Rogue take the fight. Well.
Are they gonna get the Baron? The answer is no, but they've stalled the game out long enough and got a couple shutdowns onto the side of Astralis.
Towers, they do have big CS leads in a lot of different places, but much closer game than was anticipated, and now Hansama again. The cooldown is there, it is available. Thresh gonna get absolutely obliterated. Now they're backing off, and Promise Q gets taken out.
That was such really a cool, really cool clips. It looks really good for the picks. The problem is the QSS have come in. They're going on to Trimby. He does have QSS too.
Mega Gnar, Trimby going to be in trouble. QSS not enough. That's the support taken out. Inspired looking for that opportunity. He could probably try to find a single man sleep right now. Not ideal. Traps landing on Odawamne. 6k getting lower. Odawamne, no flash available, but does have the proto belt for himself.
Sleep.
Zanzara, 3k getting lower. They want to burn it down. They want you to burn it badly. Inspired, the traps kind of zoning him out of the pit. Not sure if it's going to connect. White Knight, though, can try to get a little bit of a distance. The knockback coming in. They've knocked it back. It's clutch. Caitlyn gets it in the end. Neither spike in a matter. And now Promise Q, he lands the hook. He buys the space for Jeskla to retreat. And I cannot believe it, but Astralis
probably would have lost it. So they picked their timing well. The problem is, it does seem that Astralis picked up the Baron. And they can push in these midwaves. Handsome is going to get chunks really low now.
Huge damage. The body block coming through in the end there. But it's the power. It's 3 item Caitlyn. She's got the Storm Razor. She's got the rapid fire cannon. Single autos are going to hit like a truck if she gets to charge up that Energizer passive.
Dracos, this is huge for Astralis. They can get full bot side river control if they push in these midwaves. Rogue are going to have to back off. They need to hit one hook to win the fight, and here it could be.
This is huge. White Knight does not have Mega Gnar, and he's coming into the fight. Promise Q already caught up. The flash of the wall, not nearly enough. But Cathian Rain is there to finish the job.
Astralis now on the retreat.
That's almost like a game-winning hook here. Rogue have a numbers advantage. They still have Oduanme's ultimate, so if Astralis stack up, there could be a big cannon ult here, but I think Astralis have to fight it anyway because they're so strong on the Syndra and Caitlyn.
Larsen off to the side. Maybe they can collapse on the flank. Larsen pushing forward with the Cloyne to give himself a little bit more space. And immediately, Oduanme
is going into the pit!
They see it! They smell the blood in the water, and Astralis are knocked to pieces. Hansama furiously moving forward. He will not get taken down. The scatter, the weak will end him there with a shutdown.
The most important thing here is Oduanme has no flash, Larsen has no flash, Hans has no flash. So if Rogue step up too far, they could lose the fight.
Flash? Hook back, still a lantern there, but they're gonna break the jungler. Trimby instantly gonna get one shot as Nuke Duck also gets the knockback. Clean play from Nuke Duck. Hansama trying to step forward, but they can't walk into that pinch.
Yep, Astralis trade
inspired. Good damage coming in. Moonstone still gonna heal the team up if this takes too long, but the same is true for Astralis with the Ocean Soul. Biding our time, waiting. Oduanme off to the side, just in time for the flash to come up, but the Flay knocks it back, but still the sleep comes in its clutch. Hansama waiting for the setup. Jeskla down, now pouring through the back line. Hansama is unstoppable. It is so much damage. Nuke Duck again, the last man left standing, and Rogue managed to find the fight.
Rogue find the mispositioning on Astralis. There's a bot wave, Dracos. I think they might be able to push an end here. Nuke Duck's running for the hills. He's gonna be able to TP, but I think Trimby can just cancel this. I think Rogue can push in bot and end, and Astralis mispositions so hard for this fight.
Mispositions indeed. Nuke Duck taken down. The white flag raised, but it's Astralis' white flag in the end. Rogue pushing in, and they will end the game. It was a nail biter. It was closer than it had any reason to be, but at the end of the day, Rogue find the fight that matters when it matters most, and they are going to be able to close out this game.
Yeah, Rogue can't keep getting away with it. We saw this yesterday. Same kind of game state, same kind of comp. They did lose in the end, but they kept themselves in the game, and they just punished Astralis' mistakes so much, especially when Jessica got caught up before this fight even started.
An incredible finish, most to be certain, from the side of Rogue. At the end of the day, any collapse